GTI, look,
feel me?
I'm the best of the best, the first of the last, and I don't feel none of y'all boys, all y'all trash. Did a show last week, still counting my cast, subtract, whack, add heat, boy, that's my math. Look, ain't none of y'all messing with GT, the boy's hot, I'm the Grim Reaper on CD, believe me, I ain't gotta take none easy, won't beef, it'll get as ugly as PG. Now, me and Yachty still the killers, me roll with gorillas, GT get the spiller, yeah. Real, I kill it, Yachty, no me, no G, yeah, on the MIC, short dog do the mix, I don't lay them bricks, I lay chicks, and yeah, I just serve them the So back then at my 16, and I'm done with the mic, I'm done, and I ain't no 16, they lying to ya. I'm about 20 years old, no mouth full of gold, so the story been told, gotta make up for my last flow. So the boys like, dang, you nasty, no, I'm just an asshole. Oh. So let's bring it back a minute, GT, I let him hit it, yeah, I'm sure to get with it, I'm done. And Yachty, go and get the churro, yo, catch me and Chris going to the churro. No, I'm waiting for the last flow, cause that D4L track is killing.
What's up, this is GT Garza representing H-Town, Southwest, Swap Product, Chopaholics, Maverick Music, Mr. Maverick Music, the one and only, holla at me.
GT, when you first started on the H-Town scene, you came up through the battle circuit, man. Describe some of the battles that you went through, some of the contests that you won, and how that was, how that prepared you for the music now.
Straight through high school, through like 9th to 12th grade, I did the battle circuit. You know, traveling around Texas, flying to New York, going all around, winning competitions, you know, at B-Boy events, underground hip-hop spots or radio station spots. And then from there, after like doing as much as I could with that, I transferred and I put all my work into music. So now instead of battling, I'm trying to make music and become an artist and find the right way to come at the game and not contradict what I was doing before. And that's GT.
Man, you was all over the radio. You got some remixes on 104.9, the Chris Brown joint. It actually started off with the Paul Wall Ashanti joint. How did those collaborations come across? Like, how did you get the hook up, man? What made you the radio come to you to do that?
Oh, well, like in two. Well, see, when I was doing all those battles and everything was popping, you know, the radio station would go out there, and then you know the Chopaholics, they got their own radio show. They would be out there, so they see me, and you know they see me working hard and grinding. So you know, one day they just asked me, you know, if I wanted to be down. I was like, all right, cool. So then, you know, I linked up with all the radio people, and then they already knew me from all the battles, but they didn't really know I did music. So once I started doing more music and they saw a whole nother side of me, then it was like, okay, cool. So one time, you know, I got a call from One Jeezy to do a remix for him, because there's certain songs that certain stations can't play because they don't fit the genre. So he was like, put a rap in it, drop it, see what happens. Did it, laid it down, the next day it was on radio. So that was that. And then from there, I dropped like 4 more of them to get a buzz. And it's been building from there. People that want me to battle rap.
I'm a motherfucking star. I don't battle no more.
I'm not a star. You know what I'm saying? Battling is cool. You understand? Like, I had to pay my dues. I skipped school. Almost been jumped a couple times. People try to rob you, throw you pills, and try to put shit in your drinks and fuck you up in battles. But see, battling is cool. If that's what you do, that's what you do. If you're a battle rapper, that's cool. But if you want to become something different and try to be an artist, then do your thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my thing. I don't try to talk to nobody and be like, oh, you know, I'll battle anybody. Because that's not who I am. I'm not like that. I'm trying to do my thing and become an artist. Battling is its own league. Battling don't have nothing to do with commercial radio. Commercial radio is something totally different. Battling is its own arena, its own game. It got its own top five MCs and all that. So if you're doing battle rap, do that. If you're going to be an artist, do that. If you're an upcoming battle MC, then just don't call out everybody you can. Go do the competitions, enter, pay your dues, get to third places, get jumped, get robbed for your money, and learn what's up with the underground, because that's how it is. And then when you get somewhere and you got a name for yourself, you can talk as much shit as you want.
Yeah.
Then you can holler at me.
Yeah.
Then we can talk.
Yeah. I ain't got no more tape.
What?
Ran out of tape.
Fucking Bye Guy Productions.
Bye Guy.
Hey, we're businessmen on a budget. What up?
That's what he do. Yeah.
See your nose card. And you know this pattern's is wrong. You know, like, having sex with your clothes on. And y'all, your flow's gone. Y'all, stick to a mic. Bitch, why don't you just stick to a tampon?
GT, explain the difference that you think in your mind between like the H-Town sound, the underground battle circuit, like what the differences are and where you feel you fit into the mix.
Well, a lot of H-Town music, you know, everybody know H-Town music is real down south. You know, you go to the east or the west and they already got kind of like a, not an ear, or they kind of got like a stereotype. They put a stereotype on what down south music should be or what it already is. So underground artists, a lot of battle rap artists that haven't really came up, they set their goals out to become that artist to take us out the stereotype just for the fact that we're not labeled to what everybody else is doing. So to me, what separates battle rappers or underground rappers from mainstream rappers that are coming out of H-Town is really just people. That's pretty much it. Once people get to hear who you really are and how you coming from something totally different, they'll come onto it. And it's just like a big tidal wave.